Mphathi wehlelo.
Program director.
Ntsanza kutsatsa le lithuba, mbonge, kugutungunigete, le opportunity.
Let me take this opportunity, ubonga lithuba lomphelona.
Bishop, district overseer.
Bishop, district overseer.
Mfundisi Dube.
Mfundisi Dube.
Ngibonga kakhulu.
I thank you very much.
Ugutungunigese le lithuba, ngutingbekhona la.
For offering me this opportunity to be with you, amongst you.
Biganya ne council yonke.
Even the whole council.
Bafundisi bonge la bakhona la base alliance.
All the pastors of the alliance church.
Na labo la bavela ngapandla.
Even those that are our neighbors.
Ngiyabonga kugutsi, ningamugele la ikaya.
I want to thank you for welcoming me here in the.
Malunga ilbandla.
Members of this church.
Ngekluga shuwana ga onamusha.
From different aspects.
Kanya ne ma comrades la khona la tungswingata.
Even our comrades that are with us.
Lukfaga pagas la banya la ba ma comrades la ba khona la ibandlin.
Even the comrades that are inside of this.
I want to say thank you very much.
Sefinagutsi siyabonga kakhulu.
I would like to extend a word of gratitude to the district overseer and his executive committee for affording us the opportunity to come and congregate with you this morning.
Ngibonga lithuba le overseer aspelona kubuya slanganyele nanamhlanje.
I know there are others who would have loved to be invited, but I'm grateful that you chose us.
Ngati kukona libanga kujabulela kumenyetela kodwa kumenya kodwa likhenselisile.
This is the greatest honor of our lives with our comrades who are here today.
Uthonishwa lokukhulu kakhulu nakuma comrades laphakathi kwethu namhlanje.
This is home and I'm delighted to be here.
Ngiyathokoza kakhulu kuba phakathi kwenu.
May the good Lord continue to bless all of you and guide you through difficult times to hold and keep the body of Christ together.
Smaganze anbusise nakukhasi lekumatima kuze niqhubeke nokusekela umsebenzi kaNkulunkulu.
Because in as much as he died during this time and rose again,
njengoba esathi wafa ngalesikhathi waphindze wavuka,
he continues to live through us every day.
Uyaqhubeka uphila kithi emalanga onke.
I know that today is the day we are called to commemorate the death of Christ and his resurrection on Sunday. I want to remind you this morning that Calvary is not the ultimate thing or an end unto itself, but the means towards the end. The end being the restoration of the kingdom of heaven on earth, which we lost in the Garden of Eden because of our rebellious nature against our Creator. He brought that government back. Lohulumende, lauletil, uletelethil.
The government that is brought has brought us for us.
I want to remind you this morning that in his kingdom we are not subjects, but members of the royal family. Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, whose death and resurrection we commemorate today, is our elder brother. Everyone in God's kingdom is a prince or princess. Today, this morning, I want to utilize this time to reintroduce you to yourselves. There is an idea that you must capture, and if it captures you, you will live the rest of your life without regrets. You are going to live your life to the fullest. It worked for me. I strongly believe it can also work for you. I want to reorientate and reintroduce you to Genesis 1, chapter 26. And I want to say this morning, it is not about God, but it is about you and me. I quote, "Let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, over the livestock, over all the earth and all the creatures that may move along the ground. This is a verse that changed my life completely. But I'm ashamed to indicate to these congregants today that I started understanding this verse when I was 40 years. And I strongly feel it was the right time for me. As the country is facing difficult times, it's time that we go back to the basics and understand why God created us. If we go out today having understood fully the purpose why God created us, we'll have life and we'll have it in abundance. This statement is the first declaration of God's intent for you and me. It outlines the total purpose, assignment, potential, passion, and design of man as an entity. It is a key to man's natural desire, sense of purpose and fulfillment in life. These statements denote the transfer of power and authority from God to man, from heaven to earth and from the unseen to the scene. This is the foundation of divine delegation of responsibility for management and rulership over the earth to men. I therefore say to you this morning that I have the power of attorney to act on his behalf. This statement is crucial as it defines the nature and boundaries of rulership. It is essential to note that the human entity is not included in the context of man's domination. Uma sithi,
when we say
uNkulunkulu uthi umuntu,
God, when God says
akabe nemfanekiso wakhe,
in his likeness
and etindo ngendlela yakhe uNkulunkulu,
things his way, God's way,
andlule lapho,
and he continues and say
acacise,
he clarifies it,
ukuthi yini injongo yakhe yekwenta wena nami.
What is the purpose in which God created man for?
I'm inspired this morning to
say unto you,
uNkulunkulu wasenda,
God made us
ukuthi sibuse,
so that we can dominate
kuyo yonke into la yakhile,
everything that he has created,
lokufaka phakathi tinyoni telizulu,
which includes the birds of the heaven,
lokufaka phakathi tifish tasemandini,
which includes fish,
nako konke lakwakhile emhlabeni, nako konke lokuthi imbiwa kwasemhlabeni,
everything that God has created, even the mineral resources.
Get the secret today.
Fola imfihlo namhlanje.
Akakaze uNkulunkulu athi,
God never said
umuntu akabuse kulomunye umuntu.
He never said man must rule another man.
We clarifyile lento.
He clarified kubekwa basebaleni.
Ukuthi yini le lesifuna sibuse tikwayo.
Where do we have to rule?
Ngilapho emandla ethu ekuphila nekunjinja simo lesikhona emhlabeni akhona khona.
That's where the power to change things are resting in.
Funa kushoke ukuthi,
I want to say this.
Ngeke ukhone,
you cannot
kuphila
to live
impilo yakho to the fullest
impilo yakho ichichime
if you don't go back to the basics and understand why God created you.
Uma ungabuyeli emva kwathi uNkulunkulu kudaleleni,
ngifuna kusho bafundisi bami ukuthi,
I want to say it unto you ministers of the gospel,
umsebenzi wethu nani,
our job or our responsibility
is to go out there and change the world. How can we change the world? Go back to why God created us.
Uyela kutsi uNkulunkulu usidalelene na.
uNkulunkulu usidalele ukuthi sibuse.
He has created us to dominate.
Simanage.
He has created us to
sirule.
Sibe labo labo busako.
Kuko konke lokhu lakwakhile yena lesengubali.
He created us God.
Lokufaka phakathi umhlaba.
Which also includes the
all the departments that you come across in the world. You will find them in that statement. The Department of Agriculture is here.
Department of Agriculture.
The Department of Environmental Affairs. The Department of Minerals and Energy. The Department of Education. The Department of Health. Every department that you could imagine, you are supposed to dominate. It was created for you. Your responsibility is not to rule over people, but to manage resources. You will not be able to deal effectively with poverty, unemployment, and inequality if you don't go back to the basics. Because poverty is a result of the uneven distribution of resources. Hence, the ANC today is saying they want to institute expropriation of land without compensation. Because that is the right which was given by God during creation. How are you going to change the lives of the people if you don't have land as a resource? How are you going to change the lives of the people if you don't have water as a resource? How are you going to live effectively in the land that God created for you if you don't tap into the resources and the economy of the country? I want to say deliverance is when you leave Egypt and enter the wilderness. But freedom is when you remove Egypt from your mind. I want to tell you this morning, if we don't go back to the basics, a journey that is supposed to take 2 days, it will take 40 years. Sonke nabantwana bethu will die having not experienced freedom.
Even our children, but awufa bangingatholi inkululeko.
All of us will die having not reached the promised land.
Awufa singafike endzaweni yesithembiso.
We are supposed to rule our passions and desires and greed, drugs, power and money and possessions, but instead they often rule us.
Fanele sibuse imali, sibuse ama drugs, sibuse konke kuphuya. Esikhundleni saloko ngiko lokubusa thine. I want to say unto you this.
God is going to raise an army. Not an army that will carry weapons. An army that is going to influence the world. An army that is going to change the thinking of the people. Because the Bible says you are renewed or you are transformed by the renewing of your mind. Unless your mind changes, you will remain where you are. As long as you don't understand why God created you, you will remain where you are. God has created us to manage resources. The world owes its existence to us. The little that you think you are doing well on, God is disappointed with, because the death of Christ actually led us to have life and have it in abundance. That's why I'm saying Calvary is not the end. End lies beyond Calvary. The restoration of our lives, the restoration of our values, So that we are able to partake in the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is not our, is not like our democratic dispensation. In the kingdom of God, only God is the king. And we are prince and princesses. In the kingdom of God, you don't own anything. But you have got access to everything the Father owns. If you have got access, there is no need for competition. There is no need for jealousy. There is no need for theft. You don't need for protection. Because you are all equal and you have access to what the Father owns. South Africa needs you today. We must share in the country's wealth. And as long as we don't have land, we'll never realize our aspirations and the desires.
You think what you are having is just an abomination.
Uma athi yena uowner yonke into lekhona le ingcebo lesemhlabeni.
When God says he's owning everything that is on the earth.
Wena unaloku lo unako and you are claiming that you are doing well.
You've got what you are having ecabanga ukuthi wena unako konke.
As long as you don't go back to the basics, you will remain unemployed.
Uma ngalo ungavuyele emva ukuthi awusala ungasebenzi.
You will be poverty stricken. You will be a statistics. But uNkulunkulu wami,
my God,
uthi,
says,
kumbula,
remember
lawa wakhona,
where you fall.
Vuka,
and stand up.
Understand that precisely why he created you. That's why it becomes critical that we talk about character, which is the moral force of leadership. And I so wish Mfundisi was at a particular point, we could be introduced to our white brothers. Because it is our responsibility as a church that we pray hard, that they have a change of heart and begin to say, let us share in the land and the resources thereof, so that we can all without exception fulfill the mandate why God created us all, blacks, whites, green, brown and yellow. This land belongs to all. This land belongs to all who live in it. The defects of character in nowadays state of politics is so deep that we will not survive the next 10 years if we continue the way we do. Our governments are collapsing. Pastors are going to jail. Police are going to jail. Presidents are going to jail. Prime ministers are going to jail. Everyone is going to jail. Why? Because of defective character. Character is all you need to protect you. It is displayed in public but tested in private. The question that arises this morning is, what are you when no one sees you? Nelson Mandela was one of the leaders who embodied some measure of character that must be admired. Selflessness is what characterized his life. I want you to understand this morning that leadership is not about your skills. It's not about your academic achievement. It's not about your charisma. It's not about your power and money. But it's about attracting people to your gift and serve your gift to the world. And that service will make you big. It's about serving your gift to the world. I want to say, pastors, leaders, here, yeah, leadership is about a fruit tree. The fruit tree does not bring its fruit to you, but it attracts you to go to it. And you must understand that a fruit tree does not eat its own fruits. Therefore, the leadership that you are exercising is not about you. It's about the idea that you are carrying that will change the material conditions of the people. A true leader never seeks power. They love to empower people. Their desire is to make others great, not to make, you know, yourself greater than those that you lead. I'm reminded of two statements which were said by great leaders. One by Abraham Lincoln, which said, I quote, I have said nothing, but what I'm willing to live by, if it is the pleasure of the Almighty God to die by. What we are saying is that whatever that you believe in, that you believe can change the world, hold on it, onto it with the necessary conviction. Be prepared to die for that particular
thing.
You will change the world. If that is not the case, you will just be one of those who try to make a difference. Here is another one almost 100 years later. I quote, open quote, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to live and cherish, but if needs be, it is an ideal for which I'm prepared to die. But those are the words which were said by Nelson
Mandela.
You must understand this morning that you would not be remembered on what you compromised on. If you compromise, I guarantee you will be forgotten. Leadership is not about finding something to live for, but it is about finding something to die for. Remember, Jesus Christ started preaching at 30 years and he died at
33.
I think pastors will agree with me. He had only 3 years to change the world. And he did precisely that. Meaning now we want 3 terms of 5 years each. Lafika 15 years. Because our convictions are not bigger than our political platform. As I draw to a conclusion, I want to remind you that most people are so useless in their generation that they need a tombstone in the earth to remind us that they used to be here. You will etch your name in the hearts of humans because of your willingness to die for a cause to help humanity become what they were intended to be. That you will never be forgotten. Live in a way that it doesn't matter where they bury you. Let your life be bigger than your political grave. You would agree with me, no one knows. No one can show me where Moses is buried. But he was a great leader. He gave us all the laws that we are living according to today. I want to say, in leadership, there is no distinction between your personal life and your private life. Mfundisi awunayo a personal life. What you do privately is everybody's business. If you are a leader, the minute you spend my tax money, your private life becomes my business. I therefore live my life and keep it privately clean to protect my public life. The gift that you have is so vital that the world will be robbed by your private business.
I don't
know which verse it is in the Bible.
But what I know is that when Jesus Christ says, I give you all these laws for you to keep so that you can enjoy your memories.
There are certain people in this world. I'm just saying to the person next to you, not you directly.
There are certain
incidents that you don't want to be reminded of.
Keep God's laws so that you can enjoy your memories. Remember that the weight of your words is in your character, not your volume. The weight of your words is in your character, not the size of your words. The weight of your words is in your character, not in the sentences that you can complicatedly put together. Help South Africa become a country of integrity and honor. I want to assure you gathered here today that you will never take your children to heaven. Bring heaven to earth. Go out and change the world and make a difference in the lives of people. I want to tell you that if you keep on praying a lot, you will not change the world.
In the parliament
is the most dangerous area.
I want to tell you, Parliament, it's where they enact laws. When they pass these laws, they come into the community and they become culture.
While praying every day, they
pass a law that says,
Banvana Labangan.
Young children, they can just have sex. When they pass such bills or such laws, these laws that they are passing, they are contradicting the Bible.
So if you want to change the world, you must occupy that space. If you want to change the world, go precisely where laws are made.
I want to say this, let us go and change this world.
Asambeni umangabe singaka register anga kutsi sivote.
Let us go out and register to vote.
Asambeni siyotihlola uma ngabe singakatihloli ukuthi emagameni akhona.
Let us go to and make it a point that we are in the register, in the voters' roll.
Uma ngabe akhona.
If our names are there.
Silitshintshe lelive.
We can change this world.
Bese sivota kahle.
And make it a point that we vote well.
Bese sivotela iANC.
And vote for the African National Congress.
Amen.
We can change the world.
It's now kukula lomhlaba.
Yabo.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hey, 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 Alliance, Alliance. We have powerful people in this church. Can we clap hands for the Lord? I will request pastors to come forth. All ministers who are present here, just come forth. So that we pray for him. We believe in prayer. We believe in prayer. Prayer is the only shield we have as a church. It's the only shield we have. We can come and pray. We can come and pray. All ministers come. Most of the time, when politicians, they need prayer, they go to Moria. But we are happy that he's not at Moria. He's here. Servant of God, just say it. Just say it. I've noticed that there's Pastor Mdluli there. I don't know where is he now. No, the senior one. Then I will request Minister R.M. Dube to come. He is the one who lead us in prayer. Then we will all pray. I'm not doubting. I'm not doubting. Let me say this. We are taking it. We are possessing. In Jesus' name.
Babongcwele egameni lika Jesu Kristu wase Nazareth. Siza kuwe baba nangu babenyoni uPeter siyamazi. Babongcwele nawe futhi umazi kangcono kusedlula. Nayi le position inkosi efuneka la eMpumalanga. Abanye manje baya enyangeni bayahlanza benza konke ngoba bayifuna. Kodwa kuPeter nyoni siza ngegama lika Jesu. Sithi ngegama lika Jesu. Babongcwele seyisikhathi sokuthi abakwaziyo wena babe sembusweni. Seyisikhathi ukuthi abantu abazana nawe babongcwele bangene emandleni ukuze baba siphile kahle njengamakholwa. Siphile ngesizotha sokuthi kwesabe wena. Njengoba sibona ukusatshwa kwakho Nkosi kuncipha emhlabeni. Siyakhuleka baba sedlenyuka msize umphumelelise egameni nasegameni lika Jesu. Siyabonga baba ukuthi okungenzeke ebantwini kuwe Nkosi kuyenzeka. Sekwenzekile, sekwenzekile, sekwenzekile egameni lika Jesu Kristu ophilayo.
We can just greet him.